And it was, to me, what punk meant was it was a freedom to do whatever you wanted. It was like the rule book had been thrown out the window. You know, you didn't have to go to the Royal College of Music so you could join Yes or something like that. You could, if you knew three chords and you were willing to make an agent of yourself, you could get on a stage and join a band. Or, you know, if you wanted to be a writer, you didn't have to, you know, audition for the NME or whatever. You could write your own fanzine, you know, whatever you wanted to do, you could do. And this next song concerns itself with a fanzine, and basically a very good local one. And the guy who ran it was a guy from Bangor, and he said to me one time, he said, "We're thinking of putting a flexi disc on the cover of the next fanzine, the next issue. Is there any way you could let us have Suspect Device to put on the cover?" I said, "Well, actually, we can't, because we've just recorded it, and we're going to put it out as our first single. So, but I'll tell you what we'll do, we'll go away and write you a song." And he went, "Oh, okay, all right." So we went off and we wrote this next tune, and I thought it was pretty good. But of course, back then, you couldn't record it for him to hear, so he had to come to the next gig to hear us play it. So he turned up, and we played the song. And like I said, I thought it was pretty good. So after I went up to him and went, "So what do you think of the song, Ian?" He went, "Ah, it's fucking shite, isn't it?" So I was like, kind of deflated, but I thought, I think it's a good song, we'll keep it. So we did, we kept it. The guy who turned us down, or turned the song down, went on to actually write for the NME, and I think ended up editing The Face, and I think to this day still writes for the Daily Mirror, all of which just goes to show you what the fuck they know, because both his fanzine and the song were called Alternative Ulster.